So I got the four screws out for the card reader here. I had to take the knob off to get down in here. It just goes right back on. But it's not coming up because there's one screw there from the bracket underneath. Now I see there's the screw back here, which is part of the handle. There's two screws in the handle. The two outside ones go to the bracket. It looks like the inside ones, well, no, the inside ones go to that bracket too. So I'm going to have to take those off. But I wanted to point out, as I look at that screw down there, well, that screw's not here. But I do have one, two, three, four screws here I have to take off to get the bed off. So first I just take the hand one to loosen up the screws. Then I will take my electric screwdriver to get them out completely. Now the little screws for the card reader I put in my tray here on the right. So what I'm going to do with these four screws is I'm going to put them in that left part of the tray. And this is why I like this screwdriver, because it's magnetized. That way when I take the screw out, it stays right there. And I don't lose it. Well, that one didn't come out all the way, but I got it by hand. If you have a second person to help you, of course, it's a lot easier. And then for the handle, I could just go back here. Now when you do get the other one, just pull the handle off to the side and you can get the screwdriver to that screw. Although some of these have been in since this machine was made. So either dirt's holding them on. And as you see, one screw is longer, the outside one is longer than the inside one. Now the handle's not going to go anywhere. I can put these right in there knowing those are to the handle. So let me see if I got everything out now. Well, there's still something holding it. Oh, there's these. The latches here have screws on them as well. So let me turn this around so I don't have to. Bend over and get into my chair. So as I open up the latch, I see the screw, and it's a small head one. Let's see if this will take care of it. That's a really small screw. And, oh, there's a second one up here. So when you look underneath the latch, yeah. So you got to make sure that you use these same screws. So I could go ahead and put those screws right back in there, and hopefully it'll stay like that. But I have one more. Now the four screws on the handle, there was one here in the plastic and one on the inside of the plastic. Although I still gotta bend down. Now hopefully that's the last of them. Let me see if the bed comes up. Well, there's one bracket that's loose. Well, no, I got another screw right here that's holding the contour in place. That's the one thing that worries me is this contour. But when you take it out, just be careful that nothing comes out with it. I mean, nothing falls apart. If it does, oh well. Probably got to send it to somebody that knows how these things go together. So that one's by itself. Now let's see. Okay, now it's separating. There. Yeah, there's a little bit more rust in here. And this nut should be up here. It fell out on the side. But let me see if I could get a better picture of the inside here. Maybe you could see that rust that's right there. So I'm going to need my husband's help to get this bracket off. It's probably just from underneath the bed. Okay, there's that rust there, but I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I see some lint. Four on that bracket, four on that, although that bracket probably doesn't have to come off. I think just this center one and this right one over here. The right one could probably stay, maybe just the center one. So my husband can grind this down and paint up this bracket as well. But you saw that rust there, so let me show you the rust inside the cover. Oops, and I don't want to lose that, so I'm going to put that on there. But there, so I got some rust there. I've got some dirt and grime over there I got to clean up. I could get this off now. I'm going to just have to push that from underneath here. Some of the newer machines are going to look a little different, but basically it's the same. Look at what screws you have to take off. Wiggle a few things. I know with the 360, I was able to get the contour out. Just by a couple screws, or maybe it was four screws, but when I pulled it up, it fell apart. So if you're going to do this on the 360, make sure that contour is intact so you could put it back together. This one is set up a little different from the 360. So let me get to cleaning this and then get back to recording. And again, see, I got a little dirty, but I don't care. Dirt is part of my life. Good thing we got soap. Well, I think you could see how this is painted gray now. And my husband got these two brackets as well, and as well as the inside of the cover. I did, of course, this had to come out to get this bracket out. I probably could have taken the bracket off with this on it. I did take the right bracket off over here. That whole piece came right out, although there's two screws here that go down into this bracket. So in order for me to get this bracket off, I had to take those two screws off, which hold the contour in place. But now as I'm putting this back together, and I see the marks on this that it is centered, but if you don't see the marks on yours, this is adjustable. And what you want to do is, oh, and I forgot to mention, there were two screws from the bottom going up. I didn't put those in, because once I get this in the case, and if I don't have this adjusted just right, I don't want to take the bed apart again. I could just take the back cover off. And I do recall in the 360, it was just the four screws holding that down. So it's really no big deal. But so as I put that on the center, and I move the carriage across, I do see that the drum up here is moving the fingers. Of course, it's moving this as well. If I push it all the way forward, it's pushing it a little bit more, although now it's getting stuck there. So this is where, if you had to take the bed off, you want to check this before you go any further. When I had it tightened down before, it worked just fine. So let me just put it back in the center. What I mean the center is there's a little slide hole that these screws go into. And if you're lucky enough, you could see where the screws were before. On this side over here, I could see it. That's how I could line it up pretty good. So let me tighten these four screws down. That's a hard one because you're a little bit on an angle, as that one is. And there. It is moving the fingers. I see this moving back and forth as well. So I think I have this right. I'm going to put that on before I forget. Although if it drops off, I'll just put it on again later. So now I'm going to take the carriage off. And because I was having some lint there, I just put it in that bag. So now I'm ready to get the bed back into the case and start putting everything together. Now, I did forget how those brackets went, but I'm going to go look at my pictures. Of course, you're going to line up the holes on this bracket here so that the... And you can see from the back to make sure they line up. The holes line up with that, so. And yep, now I got this lined up. So I can get those screws put back in here. Remember, the handle screws were a little different. The one on the plastic here was longer than the one on the metal. I think that was just a plain one with a little washer on it. And then, if I'm not mistaken, that one went there. And maybe this one went over here. I have to go look at my pictures again to see exactly. And this is why I mentioned have pictures taken. So you know what goes where.